so hungry. Hey, that's such an uneasy feeling, isn't it? The bubbles in the stomach and the weird growl. Basically, my body is reminding me to get some food. But what makes us hungry? When we eat food, our stomach gets full. As we slowly digest the food, it gets pushed into the intestines. And in a few hours, our stomach starts getting empty again. This signal is sent to the brain. The brain processes it and sends it back to the stomach. This causes the rumbling that we feel as hunger. So, simply put, we can just say that when our stomach is empty, we feel hungry. Our body also has a master clock, which remembers our daily schedules. And this clock also controls our hunger. Say you eat 4 meals a day at roughly these times. Now, if you skip one of these at around the same time, you will feel your stomach rumbling. However, these clock timings are not fixed. When we change our schedules, our body takes a few days to adjust to the new schedule and the clock works accordingly. But this does not mean that we get hungry only if we skip our meals. Just like our phones lose battery after we use it all day and we charge our phones to get them back running again, when we indulge in activities like swimming, racing, playing football, or any other sport, we basically use up a lot of our energy. And when our body runs out of energy, we need to recharge it with food and water. This is the reason why we feel so hungry after a good swim. But do we only eat food when we use up a lot of energy? Or when our stomach is empty? Think again. Why is it that even after a full meal, some of us will still reach out for our favorite snack or that candy bar? Confused? Our brain is always on the lookout for food, especially the high fat and high sugar ones. Yes, the tasty ones. Just in case we need to go without food later on. Now, this may not seem very useful to us now because we have access to food almost all the time. But many years ago, when we were hunters and gatherers, loading up whenever possible made a lot of sense for survival. Today we eat things which we want and not what we need. For instance, we would love to feast on a pizza and a donut, even though these have more fats and more sugars than we need. There is a reason for this inclination. The very first time when we ate a donut, it triggered the part of our brain that releases a chemical which makes us feel happy. This explains our love for food. This also explains our cravings for food and the reason why you will sneak up to get the ice cream bar after dinner. When we are hungry, it basically means that our brains have less food to function. This means that our ability to control our emotions is reduced. This might cause a headache, some irritation, or make us hangry. Don't worry, this goes off and we calm down soon after we get food into it. Well, that's a relief. But what if we don't eat for a few days? So the first few hours, our body will use the reserve glucose for energy. After that, it will start breaking down our stored fat for energy. After about 3 days, our body will start breaking down the proteins in our muscles. And basically, we start eating our own selves. Now, we can survive like this for about 3 weeks. But how long do you think one can stay without water? Water makes up around 60 to 70% of our body. Our body uses water for way too many things. Water is also lost on a daily basis as sweat and urine. We can survive up to 3 days only without water. Hence, to maintain the water levels in our body, we need to take about 6 to 7 glasses of water daily. Looks like my noodles are here. I should eat soon. You guys don't want to see me in the hangry mode. Just kidding.
If you like this video and want to watch many more amazing videos like these, like and subscribe to our channel now.